you wish and it will be given to you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, we praise you. Jesus, we thank you.
Jesus, we thank you.
In this fine day, let us thank the Lord and praise the Lord. Let us clap the hands together with the choir and praise the Lord and say, sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, your love makes me sing. Hallelujah, 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 your love makes me sing. Your love is amazing, city and unchanging. Your love is a mountain from beneath my feet. Your love is a mystery, how you gently lift me when I am surrounded. Your love carries me.
Everybody.
Hallelujah.
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 Your love makes me sing. Hallelujah. 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 Your love makes me sing. Your love is surprising. I can feel it rising. All the joys that grow me deep inside of me. Time I see you, all your goodness shine through. I can feel the God's love rising up in me.
Everybody.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Your love makes me sing. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Your love makes me sing.
Hallelujah.
Yes, you makes me sing. Lord, you make me sing. Hallelujah. 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 Your love makes me sing.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we bless your name. Lord, we praise your name. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Let's invoke the intercession of Mother Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among us women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Please be seated. Today, we are going to meditate upon another important point in our life. We often try to get away from our sins. But there are certain things, certain sins called sins of omission. Have you heard about it? Sins of omission. Yes. There are certain sins that's called sins of omission. What does it mean? The brothers and sisters, the sins of omission is that God has given to each and every one of us a special responsibility, a special duty to do in this world. When we purposely avoid this responsibility, or when we don't do our duty in the best way possible, it becomes the sins of omission. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Word of God says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 27.
Do not hold back from those who ask you help when it is in your power to do.
The Word of God says, do not hold back to yourself the good that you can do to others when it is asked you to do. There are certain things which God wants each and every one of us to do. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
St. Paul had a lot of duties to be done which St. Peter could not do, which St. John could do, could not be done by any other pastors. Because God has destined and God has given the responsibility to each and every individual with a very special purpose. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, the word of God says, the good that you can do to others must be done by yourself. If not, it becomes a sin of omission. Maybe because of pride, or maybe because of anger, or maybe because of some other reasons, we knowingly and willingly, when we do not do certain goods which we could do, it becomes a serious sin according to the Bible. Hallelujah.
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 Dear brothers and sisters, when we go into the Bible, we see in the book of Exodus, chapter 9, verse 16, we see God is telling to a Gentile king called Pharaoh, what is the reason that God allows him to live in this world? You listen to that. 9:16 of Exodus.
But this is why I have let you live, that you may witness my power, and that my name may be celebrated throughout the earth.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The word of God clearly speaks to the Gentile king Pharaoh what is the reason of his existing. God wants this man to uphold the name of God and let the power of God be known to everyone on this earth. And that is the special reason of his existing, or God allowing Pharaoh to live in this world. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So let us imagine, if God has such a special great purpose about a person, a Gentile person called Pharaoh, what about us? We who have come to know about Jesus, who have come to know about the love of Jesus, has a special duty to and responsibility to let Jesus known to everybody. If you don't do that, it will become a serious sin of omission. Hallelujah.
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 Again, in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, we see when Saul was blinded and God asking a person called Ananias to go and heal him. But Ananias is refusing, saying that, God, how can I go? Because this man was persecuting the church. He was persecuting the Christians, was just massacring the Christians. And therefore, how will I go and heal him? Because he may harm me. He may kill me. But God sent him, saying that, no, you have to find out his house and go and touch and heal him. And this was the duty and responsibility entrusted to Ananias. And according to the word of God, Ananias went there and healed this man, Saul, from his blindness. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the duty was entrusted to Ananias, and he was supposed to do that. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, as a member of the family, as a head of the family, God has given to you certain duties and responsibilities. As a child of God, as a son or a daughter in the family, God has given you, allotted you certain responsibilities and certain good things which you have to do. And if you do not do it in the way God wants to do, it will become a sin of omission. Again, in the letter of St. James, we see in the chapter 4, verse 17, there the word of God says in this way,
anyone who knows what is good and does not do it sins.
Anyone who knows what is good and he is knowingly and willingly does not do, he sins. Hallelujah.
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 So therefore, dear brothers and sisters, our Christian life is not just doing what God has commanded us. Instead, it is going beyond that. Just keeping the commandments is not enough in our Christian life. We need more perfection. We need more growth in your spiritual activities, in your spiritual life. You have to go beyond by doing good things to others. And the word of God clearly says, And if you know that somebody is in need and you purposely deny him the good that you can do, you do a sin of omission. Often when we make the confessions, we may not do it. But in the Holy Mass, every time we repeat, oh Lord, we ask the forgiveness for those things which we have failed to do. And what does it mean? God has given you certain responsibilities. God has given us certain duties that you have to do. Dear brothers and sisters, once a man, he told me he had 3 children. And this man was very much interested in amazing wealth by doing some kind of business. And he had no time to send his children into the Sunday schools, or he had no time to train them in spiritual activities. This man would send his children to a very big school and they had a lot of education, but unfortunately they were unable to get the spiritual training. As a result, he said, all the 3 of my children, they have grown big and they have got big jobs. But Father, I feel pity because they do not have faith in God. Father, I know the reason of it, because at the right time, at the childhood, I have not done my duty to them. Because as small little kids, I never taught them the way that they have to tread. I never teach them about God because I was so much immersed in amazing wealth. And as a result, now I find that my 3 of my children, they have big jobs, they have good family, but they do not go to church. They are not practicing Catholics. I feel regret. I feel so sad. Hallelujah. So dear brothers and sisters, this parent, as a good father, he could have taught them the right way through which these children had to walk. By being a model to them, by showing a good example before them, setting a good example before the children, this man should have given them a training in their childhood. If he has failed to do that, God will ask you. And today, as you listen to this word of God, my dear parents, please think, have you done your duties well? As a father or as a mother, have you teach the children the way they have to go? Have you spoken to them about God? Have you set up before them a good example through your life that depending on God is the greatest wealth in this world? If not, you are doing a sin of omission. Today I see many parents, as the children are growing up, they are much worried. They are worried about children. One of the main reasons is that the parents are unable to teach them the way that they have to walk. Hallelujah. 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 So therefore, my brothers and sisters, today, let us just recall to our mind how many occasions we had to love and serve the people, to do even small helps to people, because of our anger, because of our jealous nature, because of our envious nature, because of our pride, we must have done, or we also neglected so many occasions to do good. And be sure God is going to ask you for this. Because the word of God says in the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 12, verse 47, a servant knows what the mind of his master, and if he doesn't do accordingly, he will be very severely punished. So what does it mean? We know our life is a gift from God. God has given us this life as a free gift. And God wants us to do certain things which can be done by me alone, which can be done by you alone. And if you don't do that, it becomes a very serious sin. Hallelujah. Letter to Ephesians, chapter 2, verse 10. The word of God says, we are handiworks of God, and we are created in this world for certain purposes which are predestined before the creations of the world. And therefore, be sure our duties and responsibilities are entrusted to us by God. And unless and until we don't do it, we are failing in our life and in our aim. Let us stand. We ask the Lord, would you please close your eyes? And let us please repeat after me. the prayer which I say. Almighty Father, everybody together. Almighty Father,
Almighty Father,
we praise and thank you.
We praise and thank you
for giving
our
lives, as mere gifts. Today,
as we pray,
we ask you forgiveness.
We ask you forgiveness
for all those moments.
For all those moments
in which,
we
have failed to help others.
We have failed to help others.
We have failed to do our responsibilities.
We have failed to do our responsibilities
in the best way possible.
In the best way possible.
Oh Lord. In our past lives. We have neglected.
So many times.
The goods that we could do. Lord.
Give us the grace.
To do good.
In every circumstance.
For the greater glory of God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Let us praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Glorify you, Lord. Oh, Lord, we thank you for giving this gift of life.
Hallelujah. Your love makes me sing.
Hallelujah.
Your love makes me sing. Yes, you makes me sing.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May God bless each and every one of you.
Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, we praise and thank you. We glorify and worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let's clap the hands and sing and dance before the Lord. Clapping the hands, looking up to Jesus. Let's sing together. Lord, show your power.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus, we thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus, we praise you and glorify you, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We proclaim that you are the only Savior. Oh Lord, touch us and heal us. We need your touch. Oh Lord, if we want to have a long-lasting change in our life, we need to have a transformation in our life. Oh Lord, your grace is needed to us. And today as we are here before you, Lord, you know our weaknesses. You know our shortcomings. Oh Lord, you know how unworthy servants we are. We are in this world and the world is corrupted. And this corruption has come into our hearts and minds. Lord, we ask your deliverance. Lord, send forth your Spirit. And all those who are led by the Spirit are the children of God. We need to live a life of holiness. Oh Lord, today as we are before you, give us the grace to be a messenger of your love. To give us the grace to redistribute the graces that you have given to us to each and everyone who comes to us. Lord, help us to sanctify our families. Help us to sanctify our bodies, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Oh Lord, we ask your grace. We ask your power. We ask your mercy. Let us keep both hands close to your heart. We ask the Lord. Surrender ourselves totally and fully. Oh Lord Jesus, we are in your presence. We need your blessings. We need your grace. Now let us submit all our petitions, submit all our supplications, our needs and desires. Lord, as you raise your hands up to bless us, we would like to thank you in advance. We believe strongly that whatever is our desire, you will sanctify and fulfill us. Let's raise the hands up to heaven. As we receive the blessings, let the grace come down on each and everyone who participate in this. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Raising the hands up to heaven. Looking up to Jesus. Let us praise and thank the Lord. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment.
Let's bow down.